Nanny? Nanny? Diana? I'm glad to see that you're still working here.
How are you, sir?
What's with the sir? You sound like we were never friends. I guess they don't call you Hopia anymore because you've lost a lot of weight.
Edward? Edward!
See you.
I'm glad you still remember me. But you know, I'm still a bit mad at you for leaving like that. You left without saying a word. You didn't even say goodbye. I never heard a thing from you. You didn't even write. But then who am I to expect that from you?
Hey, Hopia. Wash my pants, will you? Make sure they be dry by tomorrow. I'm going to use it. I'm going out. I don't have anything else to wear. Is that clear? Are you listening?
Yes, I'll do it.
Hey, Hopia. Scratch my back, will you? It's itchy. I can't reach it. There, in the middle.
This part?
Yes, but a bit lower. There.
Here?
Yes. Right. There.
We never changed a thing in your room, Edward. It's the same as we left it. All right. It's about time you rested.
Thank you.
Whenever you're nervous, just give it a ring. You'll remember me, and you'll feel better.
Santos!
Next.
Here, you still owe us 70 passes from last week.
I'll pay next week.
Barmeo!
Okay, next.
Sir, can you go a little faster?
And why are you in a hurry?
That's right.
Well, I'm going to the city to pay for our placement fee.
The plan to work overseas is pushing through.
Well, I hope so, once they approve our papers.
Is that so?
See you.
Off with you then. Next.
Herbert!
Sorry, miss.
Herbert!
Miss, I'm sorry, I didn't see you.
Why are you taking a leak here anyway? This is a cane field, not a toilet.
What are you so mad about? I didn't do it on purpose.
Please say yes, Beatrice. All I want is a date. If you want, I can carry your things for you.
No, thanks. I can do it. Come on, stop bothering me, please. Guys, you heard what I said. No, okay?
Beatrice.
So annoying.
Don't be annoyed. We just want to ask you out on a date.
You know, there are a lot of other women out there. Try asking them out instead of me.
Come on.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir.
Hi.
Good evening. Where are you going?
Sir?
I said, where are you going?
Well, I'm on my way home.
Hop in. I'll give you a ride.
Sir?
Hop in. I'll take you home.
night.
Good night. Were those guys being rude to you?
You mean them? Oh, no, sir, they're just being pesky. You know, sir, it's the first time I've ridden such an expensive vehicle. It's so nice. It smells so good and so very clean.
Beatrice already fell asleep inside the bus.
Be careful on your way.
Sure. Take care of yourself, too, okay? We'll be back soon. Right, let's go, mister.
Sophia? Bring me back something.
Sure. Goodbye.
Remember, Edward, don't ever do anything to embarrass me.
As always, Father.
Father. Watch over him.
Yes, I'll take care of my grandson.
Okay.
He gave me just 2 weeks. Just 2 weeks, Grandfather. Just a short time for me to do everything I need. And after this, it's back to reality again, a very painful reality.
Please excuse me, I still have work.
Diana, wait.
And he offered to drive me home in his car. And that was the first time I rode such an elegant vehicle. Aside from that, gosh, he even opened the door for me. Isn't he such a gentleman, Sophia?
Oh, really? I think you better be careful every time you're around him. I don't trust that Edward one single bit, Beatrice.
How come?
I was walking through the fields. I was startled to see him standing in front of me taking a leak.
Edward?
Yes, Edward. Who else?
But wait. I don't think Edward would do that on purpose if he saw you.
Look, Beatrice, that is not the point. It's a cane plantation, not a toilet.
Well, who knows? His bladder was full. He just had to go. Then again, you might have passed there on purpose, just so you can see him yourself.
Huh? I'm not as foolish as you, okay? I'm not about to do idiotic things just to get noticed. Wake up from your fantasy, Beatrice. It's no use. Men like Edward won't go for women like us. He's totally out of our league.
Next time I know you'll be batting liquid. Shampoo.
I know you're still mad at me.
I'm not. All that happened a long time ago. More than 10 years ago, in fact. I've forgotten about it.
No. I'm sure we both haven't forgotten it. Diana, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
No. I know you were deeply hurt. I know this is stupid. But this is the only way for you to forgive me.
Wait, what are you doing?
Apologizing.
Are you serious?
Of course I am. S? O?
Look, you don't have to do this. It's really fine with me, you know?
No, 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 of course not. I'm not embarrassed. S? O?
Was that an S?
Yes, it was an S. R? R?
Why?
Sorry? Shouldn't you make it sorry, Diana?
What? You only spelled out sorry for me before. It should have been sorry, Edward.
But what you did was more serious than what I did to you before. So I guess you'd have to do more.
Fine. D. I. A. N. A. Sorry, Diana. I saw the red kite and I thought it was yours.
I don't do that anymore. No Superman came to me anyway.
You know, that day when you left, I did see your red kite flying. If you only knew how I wanted to jump out of the car just to run to you. To save you like I promised you. But then, it was too late.
Let's forget about that. It's all in the past.
How could I ever forget? People seldom depend on me. You did. And yet I failed you.
You didn't even write me a letter. But I guess all men are just like that. You're just not into writing. You're not that sentimental.
Diana, I said I'm sorry. Do you want me to sway my hips again?
Never mind. It looks so ugly.
No, no, you don't have to stand up. Where are the plates?
Here.
No, I'll do it. Go ahead and sit.
Sorry, I think I ate too much earlier.
Wow. It's okay.
Come on. Stop laughing, will you? Can't you see I'm already embarrassed?
No. I miss times like this. You see, I never laughed as much. Aside from that, you know what? I've met a lot of people around the world. But still, there's only one person who can make me laugh like this. Avec toi, ma maison comme un enfant.
What's that?
Ich bin glücklich, wenn dir denn.
Hey, that's unfair. You learned those words from the different countries you went to. I wouldn't understand that.
One more. Y te extraño.
Whatever.
I would have killed those wretched parasites when I saw them beating you up. Don't worry. We'll soon be able to leave this place for Hong Kong. From now on, you'll be living with me, Hopia.
Yeah, that's right.
How could they do this?
Just forget about them. Besides, they were the ones who took Mother and I in when we had nowhere else to go.
But that doesn't give them any right to beat you up like this. They're just good-for-nothing imbeciles.
Diana? Look at this. I bought it in Manila.
What are you doing? Can't you see? Hopia's just been beaten up here. You are so insensitive. Is that all you can think
of? Come on, Sophia. I was just...
You know, I don't understand you at all. You say you have no money for the placement fee and you borrow from me. But when it comes to trifles, you have money.
But this doesn't cost much. Come on, let's try it. I'll put it on first.
I'm sorry.
Hey, look. Isn't it pretty? Here, Dana. It's your turn. Try it on.
Will you stop it, please?
What? Let's just try it. I'll just put on a little. Wow, it's nice. There, give us a smile. Your turn, Sophia.
Beatrice, I don't think it looks good on me.
No, it looks pretty. Your turn, Sophia.
This is no time.
Come on,
Beatrice. This is no time for a beauty lesson.
Just a
You're
bit.
So obnoxious.
See, it's so beautiful. Wait.
Look, she has turned me into a clown.
Wait a minute. Come on, look. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who's the fairest of them all?
This is so hard. I don't know which thing I should fear more. The life I'm leaving behind me, or the one I'll be facing. Even if I wanted my life before, what did I like about it? It was always other people. I always did what they said.
Edward, you have to use the moment that you're given now. Just do everything that you want to do, while... You're still free while you're still in charge of your own life.
But then why me? How come my brother was able to turn his back on them?
But in the end, Edward, everything is up to you. You can either turn your back on it all like what your brother did, or just do what your father wants you to do. Whatever you choose, bear in mind that you chose what is right. Remember my words, Edward. What you want for yourself is not important here. Do what you need to do because it's the right thing.
We'll be leaving this place soon. All our dreams will come true once we arrive in Hong Kong. We're going to be rich! I won't have to go back to this cane plantation. You know, I imagine the day when all this land will become all mine. Because when I come back, this entire land, as far as I can see, will all be under my name.
And in this vast stretch of land, this is where my prince will come.
Here we go again. You know what? There's nothing inside that brain of yours except for Edward. Why don't you just forget about that guy? We're about to go to Hong Kong.
Up to now, your uncle still beats you up? How I wish I was there to protect you from them.
No need. You see, it won't be long anyway. When I leave, I don't have to see them ever again.
You're leaving?
Yes. Together with Sophie and Beatrice to Hong Kong.
Maybe it's all for the better. Maybe you'll meet a rich Chinese man there.
Well, maybe. Besides, my eyes look like theirs. And if I'm lucky, maybe they won't notice how overweight I am. How about you? When you go back, I'm quite sure you'll be entertaining a lot of nice women.
It's possible. Beautiful, wealthy, sexy.
There are many rich Chinese men in Hong Kong, too.
You're right. You might get married to one of them, too. Besides, you look Chinese anyway.
He's going to be lucky. Because I'm a great cook.
They don't like coconut candy.
I know how to cook other dishes, too, you know.
My grandfather will sure miss you cooking for him. But he'll find someone to replace you. Let's go. Hop in.
Never mind. I think I'll just walk.
Hi. Don't worry, you're safe. We're so glad you woke up.
I don't think there's any need to bring her to the hospital. All you need is a little rest. Maybe you were just shocked, that's why you lost consciousness. But don't worry, the car didn't hit you.
I've already told your friends. We'll be right outside, so that you can rest better. I'll also have food sent up. See you. The doctor said she's fine. There's nothing to worry about.
You're lucky that your car didn't hit me. Otherwise, I would have sued you.
I'll drive you home.
No need, thank you.
Thanks, Sir Edward. We'll go ahead. So, Sophia, can you still say Sir Edward's arrogant? Not only did he attend to you, but he also let you lie down on their big soft bed.
I deserve it. He almost ran me over anyway.
Sir Edward is such a gentleman, isn't he? I think I'm starting to fall for him.
Beatriz, if you fall on your face, no one will catch you.
What's wrong with falling for him? You're such a pessimist. Come on.
Beatrice.
Why?
I came here to tell you something important about Edward.
Who? Edward? Really? What? He said something about me? Did he want me in the mansion? Hopia, do you still feel anything for Edward? Really? I guess that means you can help me snag him. Because you know what I think? I notice him, and I'm not dreaming. Sometimes, he gives me a certain look. You know, just like it's possible he's in love with me. Like that. What do you think?
Of course it's possible. Well, you're so pretty.
That's what I like about you. You always tell the truth. But seriously, can you really help me get closer to Edward? Because I see that you know him pretty well. Besides, if he was kind enough to take me home in his car that night and managed to take care of Sophia and the mansion, right? Then that probably means he doesn't look down on people like us, even if we're poor. Right? And it's possible he could fall in love with someone like me. What do you think?
Please. All right, Beatrice, I'll try.
Really? Oh, thank you, Hopia! Thank you so much! He's on his way back here, so just wait for him. You can hitch a ride to the mansion, huh?
I'm not going to the mansion today. I don't feel well.
Why, what's the matter? Are you sick, Diana?
I'm fine. I think I just need to rest.
Gosh, then you should eat some fruits, take some medicine, and drink a lot of water. And look, you have a fever. All done. I'll
okay.
Serve it.
Here, just one more thing.
Oh, good morning, Sir Edward. Excuse me.
Sir Diana is not feeling so well, so Beatrice volunteered to help out in the kitchen.
Excuse me.
Brianna. Are you avoiding me?
No, I'm not. It's just that I have a lot to do. I hope you don't mind. I don't think we should see each other.
All our documents are good and ready. We can leave for Hong Kong anytime soon, girls. You can start packing your bags, but remember, don't bring too much, okay? If we need something, we can just buy them there.
Sophia? I know you're going to be angry at me, but I was thinking maybe...
What is it, Beatrice?
What if I change my mind and not go to Hong Kong?
What?
You know, I made something delicious. You should try it.
Beatrice.
Come on. Let's discuss this later.
No! We'll talk about it now. What did you just say, Beatrice?
I was worried about Grandmother Amelia. I don't want to leave her alone.
Come on, don't use your grandmother as an excuse. You've never done that before. You know me, Beatrice. I always tell the truth. So you better tell me the real reason behind this so I can believe you.
Look, Sophia, I never really dreamt of going to Hong Kong anyway.
Beatrice.
Well, it's always been my aim to leave this poor town together. We are leaving this town. No one gets left behind.
Sophia? Maybe I'm contented with this kind of life. Maybe I don't aim as high in life as you do. And maybe I am stupid to choose a simple life. So if I'm going to be the reason for you not to fulfill your dream, then just leave me here.
It's Edward, isn't it? He's the reason why you don't want to leave.
Sophia.
Are you still deluding yourself that he'll fall for you?
And what if I say yes? What's
wrong
with that?
Have you gone crazy, Beatrice?
Then let me be crazy then. We've all gone crazy to reach for our dreams anyway.
After all I've done to obtain these documents, after I've worked like a dog to get the money, this is what you do to me?
Sophia, wait a minute. That's enough.
Come to think of it, have you ever asked us if we wanted to come? Did you ask us if we wanted the life that you wanted for us, Sophia? You know, Sophia, the truth is, you're just afraid to fail. That's why you want us there. Because once you fail, you drag us down as well.
Beatrice...
I never wanted anything but a better life for the three of us. To leave this awful place together. I've always known we can do better than this life. So don't call me crazy, Beatrice, and I am not selfish. You're all part of my plans, and if I succeed, we all do. But is this what you thought about me all along? How can you be so ungrateful? Just because of one man... You're ready to turn your back on all of our dreams. Dreams we've worked hard to achieve.
Fine. To you, I may be dumb. But Sophia, I admit what I feel inside my heart. Call me insane if you want. There's Beatrice still hoping one day her prince will come. There's Beatrice deluding herself. Fine. I am nuts. But at least I'm true to myself, Sophia. You always say what's on your mind even if it hurts someone else's feelings. Why, Sophia? Have you ever admitted to yourself that you still love your mother? And that even if she already left, you're still hoping she'll come back? Now, Sophia, say it to my face. Am I the only one crazy about Edward? Didn't you ever think that he might help you fulfill all your dreams in life? And while you were lying in his bed in the mansion. Sophia, don't tell me you never wished how it would be to lie there every night as Edward's wife.
Thank you.
consider me a bad friend, Diana? I may look like I'm running your life, but all I wanted was a much better life for the three of us away from this town. The three of us. There's a whole world out there. Ever since the day my mother left me, I've never had any other family except the two of you. That's why I'm ready to give my own life for your sake. I could kill for you if I had to.
Hush now, Sophia.
You know, William, if you didn't leave all the burden to me, my life wouldn't be this complicated.
Edward, we're all capable of making our own decisions. I decided I've had enough. I've had it. I don't want them controlling my own life. I want it to be free. Free from the whims of our father.
And what? Now why am I supposed to shoulder all the responsibility that should have been yours?
You gotta refuse it if you want. Do what I did.
William, I'm not like you.
Go, step on it. Go kill ourselves. Edward. Edward. I know this is hard for you. And it's partly my fault.
All my life they've ordered me around. And now even what I'm supposed to feel? William, I'm supposed to get married. And I don't even love the woman I'm going to marry. I have no choice but to do what they tell me.
Edward, you're just going to suffer. If you will do what they say, you'll just break up to pieces. Why don't you ask yourself if you can live that kind of life? And if not, there's still time. You can still back out.
They're counting on me, William. You already left them. I can't do the same thing to them. May I use this?
Sure, sir.
Some more ice. Could be winter.
Some more ice. It's a record. Have they all ordered?
Waiter.
the father. I'm not going to marry that girl.
To hell with them all! Yes, sir! Beatrice?
Sir Edward?
Is Diana in her house?
I've no idea, sir. I don't think so.
Where are you going? You want to hitch a ride?
All right.
Wow, what luck. Wait here.
Shelter over there. Let's go.